Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV, brought to you by Adorama. It's the camera store that has everything for photographers like you and me. I'm Mark Wallace, and I've been zipping around the world on a motorcycle for about 2 years, and about 2 years previous to that, I've zipped around the world on planes, trains, automobiles, and tuk-tuks, and all kinds of things. And so I've been traveling around for about 4 years now. I've been outside of the United States, and for people that have been following me on Instagram and on YouTube here on Adorama TV and Facebook, there have been some questions that have been asked recently. And those two questions are, number one, can I give an overview of my current camera setup, the camera that I'm using every day? And for those that have been following me for a while, they really want to know, why did I upgrade from an M Type 240 to the M Type 10? It's an expensive upgrade, so why did I do that? And so I'm going to try to answer those questions in this video. I'm going to try to do that as quickly as possible. And so the way I'm going to do that is try to explain the differences about the M10 versus the M Type 240. And so if you're just joining in and you've never seen a video from me before, you might want to watch a couple of other videos that I've done specific to the Leica M system. The first one is the reason I switched from a Canon system to a Leica system. This was a few years ago, and so I go into detail about why I did that specifically for travel. And then I made another video about a year later that was a review of the things that I loved and things I think that could have been better with the M Type 240. And all of that information still applies to the M10. And so this video, I'm just going to talk about the differences between the M10 and the M240 and about why I upgraded and the things that I think are significant. So if you're new and you're looking for information about the M specifically, check those other videos out first and then watch this one. The links to those videos are in the description of this video. So you just go down there and click that and you can check all that stuff out. All right, so very quickly, the gear that I'm using now is almost exactly the same as what I've been using for the last few years. So I've got a 50 millimeter Sumilux lens. This is a 1.4 lens. This is what I use for portrait work. If I'm in the studio or if I need to shoot in low light, this is a fantastic lens. I have a 35 millimeter lens that is on my lens. This guy right here is a Summicron M. This is F2 lens. This is the workhorse lens that I use almost every single day. I made a video about this actually. And so again, that video is linked in the description of this video. So check that out. I got a new little lens here. This is a 28 millimeter Voigtlander. This is an Ultron 1.9 lens. This is a vintage lens. And I made a video about this, so check that out. Again, links are in this video. And then I have a 21 millimeter lens that I use for my street photography, any kind of photojournalism kind of work that I use. I absolutely love this lens. It is probably the sharpest lens I have ever used. It is fantastic. I have a viewfinder that goes along with this 21 millimeter lens, and I have the new Visioflex electronic viewfinder for the M10. It's one of the differences. All right. So that's the current gear I have. If you really want to see how I put this into everyday use and what each lens looks like and how I get the most out of it, follow me on Instagram. You can see all of the images that I've shot with this camera, and I always post the metadata, so which lens, the camera, and the settings that I've used. So check that out. Make sure you follow me on Instagram. You can see more of these lenses and how I've used them because we don't have time to spend all of that to go through each one of these lenses individually here today. Okay, so I have a cheat sheet up here I'm looking at. So I want to talk about the differences specific to the M10 versus the M Type 240. Now, there are some small differences, and these are differences that are significant, but they weren't significant enough for me to upgrade. And so specifically, M10 finally goes back to the old naming conventions, and so it's not a secret which the latest M camera is. It was really confusing when they went from M8 to M9 to M Type 240 and the MP and the MP monochrome or whatever. So it was confusing. So now they're back to just standard M10, and I hope they keep that, maybe an M10 monochrome, M11, M12. So sanity has returned to Leica. That's really cool. The body is slimmer, so now the body is about the same size as the analog film cameras, and so it's much, much more ergonomical. I love it. I have added on my camera, by the way, a thumbs up. You can get a thumbs up for most mirrorless cameras, so if you've got a Sony or a Fujifilm or Leica, whatever, you can get these, and it just allows you to hold the camera like this, a thumbs up. And so I absolutely love it. I didn't have that with my 240. I wish I did. It's really, really fantastic. The other thing that they've done with the M10 is the menu system, the buttons on the back are much more simplified. There aren't as many buttons back here. The actual menu system is easier to use with an M10. And with the camera itself, now all of the key controls are analog controls and they're out there. You don't even have to have the camera turned on. You can change the ISO. There's an ISO dial right at the top. There's a shutter speed dial right there. Your aperture, you're always manually controlling that. You have manual focus. So ISO, aperture, shutter, right there. They're analog manual dials, so they're right there. Also, you now just have an on-off switch and a shutter release button. You don't have, this doesn't have multiple different modes to take you into different drive modes, high speed, low speed, etc. It just turns on and off. To change the drive mode now, you do that in the menu system itself. The other change that I think is significant is now the buffer on the M10 is twice as big as the M240. So it's a 2 gigabyte buffer, which allows you to shoot up to 40 JPEG images if you're shooting that. Really what it does is now when you're shooting quickly, the camera doesn't bog down. So you're not missing shots. And so I wasn't really missing a lot of shots with the M240, but occasionally I'd be like, come on, camera. So that is gone as well. It's really cool things. There are some small negative things I want to mention before I get to the big game changers that led me to upgrade. So let me talk about the small negative things. One of them, and for me, actually, it's not a big deal, but there is no longer video. So you cannot shoot video with the M10. The M240, you could shoot 1080p 30, I think. But the M10, there's no video capability at all. That's gone. So if you're looking to shoot with a Leica and using video, either get an old 240 or get the Leica SL. The Leica SL is really where it's at for video if you want a Leica and Leica lenses. Or get a Sony or get a Fujifilm or a Canon or a Nikon, etc. So the M10 is not a video deal. Also, one of the things they've eliminated that is highly annoying for me is the M240 used to have an electronic level. So you could see on the back if your camera was crooked and so you could make sure everything was level. For whatever reason, that is gone in the M10. So the electronic level that I used constantly is gone. Also, they've eliminated some of the guides in live view. So there used to be 16x9 guides and 4x3 guides. Those are gone. I don't know why they're gone. Now they only have a rule of thirds guide and you have a grid, a four lines across, six lines down grid, 4x6 grid. But the truth is, in live view, those grids, those guides, are virtually invisible. Really, the only way to see them is to use the external electronic viewfinder, and so that's a bummer. So maybe in some firmware upgrades, they'll bring back the level, and they'll bring back the old guides, because I really like those guides because I shoot stills for videos, so I want to see that 16x9 aspect ratio. So maybe they'll fix that in the future, but again, those are really not big deals. So what are the big deals? What are the things that led me to change? Well, the heart of an M camera is the viewfinder. And the M10 has a viewfinder that has a 30% larger field of view, which means it's much easier to see things. It's much easier to use the 28mm lens on this camera. You're not looking at the corners trying to figure out whatever. It's just so much easier to see. And the magnification is larger, so it's 0.73. versus 0.68 on the M240. So that means if you're using longer lenses like a 90 or 75 or 135, it's much easier to focus. So the viewfinder is so much better. Also, the eye relief distance has increased by 50%, which means it's just easier to see things. It's better for people that wear glasses to be able to see exactly what's going on there. So if you're using this for the viewfinder, which is really the heart of the M and why you'd buy it in the first place, this is so much better. And of course, the parallax correction is working just fine. It's a Leica, so duh. Obviously, the parallax is going to be corrected in the viewfinder. That's what makes this camera so wonderful. All right, but the huge difference, the heart of my upgrade, was the ISO performance. So on the M Type 240, really about ISO 800 was the max that I found that was acceptable. Anything over that was just too noisy and too nasty. And so that was really a drag, and I think I mentioned that in my last video, my review. So this camera, the base ISO is now 100 instead of 200, which is fantastic. So if I'm shooting in the studio, when I control ambient light, it's much easier to do that with one stop lower base ISO. And then the top end of the ISO is now 50,000. So it finally puts this camera into the realm of a modern day digital camera. Now the practical, what is usable, I'm shooting all the time at ISO 3200, 6400, 12,800, and so I'm using it way up in the higher ISO ranges. 50,000 is something that you can use, but it's, again, it's not really usable, it's not practical. You can use it if you absolutely have to, but now this camera has high ISO ranges that are coming into the modern era. Now again, this camera that's got a new sensor, it really, if you're looking for high ISO, low light performance, even though this is great, it still doesn't keep up with Nikon and Canon and Fujifilm and Sony. And so Leica has a little bit of room to grow in that area, but it is a significant improvement over the Leica M Type 240. So if you're looking for the small Leica M camera rangefinder with these exceptional lenses, but still need a boost in ISO performance, that one thing for me was worth the upgrade. So that low light performance really has changed my entire world. Now the difference in image quality between the older Leica M240 sensor and the newer Leica M10 sensor, there are, if you look at all the different technical tests and all that stuff, there is an improvement, but for everyday practical use, they're about the same. They're both spectacular. They're both really, really amazing. And so technically there are better, the new M10 gathers light in the corners a little bit better. It's got a little bit higher dynamic range. There's some other things about it that make it better. But when you just look at your computer, they're about the same until you start getting into the high ISO range. And that's really when this camera starts to sing its praises. It's really, really good. The other big difference between the M10 and the M240 is something I didn't even expect, didn't really know about. I sort of saw that in a small fine print, but I've started to use it all the time. And that is, the M10 has built-in Wi-Fi. So you can turn this guy on, and it has two modes. You can either have the camera create its own Wi-Fi hotspot, which is what I do. It's great if you're in a coffee shop or something and you want to transfer images to your iPad or your iPhone. And right now it's only iOS. It only transfers to iOS, so that's a negative. Maybe that will have changed by the time this video goes out. We'll see. But you can wirelessly now transmit images to your iPhone or iPad. And then you can bring those in as DNG files to Lightroom CC. You can edit those, and that makes it really quick and easy if you want to post things to Instagram on the go from your Leica. And that's how I've been using it. It's really, really awesome. I just bring the images from Wi-Fi into my phone, edit those on Lightroom, export those to Instagram, and bam, I have images uploaded on the go. I really, really love that. The app also allows you to control the camera, and so you can tell the camera to take a picture. You can't change aperture values from the app because it's all manual. You can't control the shutter or ISO values either because, again, those are all manual. So you can't really do that from the app, but you can say, hey, take a picture. That works just fine. And you can also go into the menu system and change some things about the camera itself from an iPhone instead of using the menu on the back of the camera. So the Wi-Fi is muy bueno. I really, really like it. It's something that I've used that I didn't really expect. The other thing that I really love is the new electronic viewfinder. So when you put the electronic viewfinder on an M10, it transforms the M10 from a rangefinder camera to a true modern day mirrorless camera. And the old M240, the viewfinder was a little bit slow. It wasn't very high resolution. This is the VisioFlex electronic viewfinder that's used on other Leica cameras, and it is wonderful. It's big, it's really clear, it's very colorful, it's high resolution, it's articulated, it's easy to change the diopter, so if you need to change that, if you're wearing glasses or anything. If you want a normal mirrorless camera with an electronic viewfinder, just get the electronic viewfinder, throw it on there, and now you're using this as you would a Sony or Fujifilm or any other mirrorless camera, and you don't have the viewfinder. You're actually looking through the lens. You're seeing all the information just like you would on a modern camera, which is really, really awesome. The other thing about this is this has a GPS receiver built in, and so when you attach this to your camera and you're shooting on location, you're doing travel photos, what will happen is this will automatically geotag your images, and so you know exactly with pinpoint accuracy where you took each image. So if you want to know exactly where you were when you took your travel or scenic photos, this will do that for you perfectly. All right, well, that's it. Those are the big differences for me. Bottom line, the ISO performance was what made me jump from the 240 to the M10. But I also love the performance of the new electronic viewfinder, the simplified system, and the simplified menus and dials and settings. It's just really a wonderful, wonderful system to use. And so if you're thinking about it, I say do it. It's awesome. I really love it. If you want to know more about the M system and what a rangefinder is versus a mirrorless camera, make sure, again, you will look at those other videos that I've already talked about. Well, thank you so much for joining me. I hope this answered a few questions about my gear and the reason why I upgraded. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV. That way you don't miss a single thing. You can sort of follow the journey as I zip around the world. You can follow the journey as Gavin Hoey does his series of images and his tutorials and updates. We have Tamara Lackey and Vanessa Joy. We've got David Bergman. We've got all kinds of people. And all of them, including myself, we do our videos in series. And so one leads to the next that leads to the next. So make sure you subscribe or you might miss out on some really cool stuff. Thanks again for joining me. Make sure you follow me on Instagram, and I will see you again next time.